Hi, this is a short video of the solar system I set up. Okay, this is the battery bank. It's four 115 amp deep cycle marine batteries hooked in parallel. So it'll store a maximum of about 460 amp hours. There's three inverters I use for the power. 1000 watt on the bottom, 400 in the middle, and a 150 here on top. Pretty much just use the 1000 watt inverter now for power. A couple of voltmeters there to keep an eye on the battery levels, and the white box on top is a 25 amp hour charge controller. Okay, from there I'll backtrack. There's a cord that runs along the floor outside. I'll just give you a quick look at the panels. It's what it is a 12 1 amp 15 watt panels. Kind of sunny out here, just good, but hard to see. Here they are, again, 12 1 amp panels, 15 watts apiece, for a total of 180 watts per hour on the best of sunny days. Okay, so from there, batteries get charged up, inverters, two cords run pretty much all around the house, down the hall, bedroom and bathroom with lights and fans down there. And pretty much all the lights and fans in the living room are solar powered too. So there's one there, a couple there, and the floor fan, along with the TV, stereo system, smaller radio. Having that pretty much all powered on solar now. Toaster, blender, and I bought a small microwave that just barely runs on the 1000 watt inverter, but it seems to work okay. Moving down to the bathroom real quick, not really much to see in here. Quickly, that razor is powered on solar, lamp on solar, and let's move from there to the bedroom. In the bedroom, pretty much just lamps, those two lamps, that lamp on the dresser. My computer, I sometimes run on solar, but not always, and a fan or two on solar as well. So as far as the price of the system, I bought pretty much everything I needed for about $1,300. That even includes the cables and pretty much everything. $1,200 to $1,300, so not too bad. As far as runtime, if I'm just running the fans and a house full of lights, I can run it about 8 hours a day, or a night I should say. If you throw on the TV, make a sandwich on the sandwich maker in the kitchen, and run the microwave a couple of times for 6 to 10 minutes, then probably 5 hours a night, which really works out perfect for me. And what I found is these 115 amp hour batteries pretty much balance out well with a full day of sun and a three panel set from Harbor Freight Tools. Again, for about $200, they'll sell you three 1 amp panels with everything you need, pretty much, except the battery and the inverter to get started. So four batteries hooked to four sets of panels, 12 panels total, three in a set. Run the extension cords around the house. Everything seems to work well. Pretty much use CFLs in the lamps, so 15 watters, some 15 watt ones, some 20 watt ones. You'll get 75 to 100 watts of actual power, as if it was incandescent. They work well. Probably the biggest draw, again, would be the microwave. I think it's a 600 watt microwave, but that is just cooking power. Actually runs about 850 to 900 watts. I do recommend buying a kilowatt meter to test all your appliances. I found the ratings on them are sometimes totally inaccurate. Typically an appliance will run higher. It'll say 850, it'll run at 950. Not good, but it's good to know. So you can buy a kilowatt meter at Harbor Freight Tool. Harbor Freight Tools as well. The batteries I actually bought at Walmart, they're about $72 a piece out the door. Again, 115 amp hour a piece. It's a really good, good solid, good size battery. So, that's about it. Feel free to comment if you have any questions, or where I got this stuff, or how to hook it up, or safety issues involved in this. But let me think here. Yeah, that's about everything. So again, It's really good. I can run all the small appliances. The only thing I haven't done yet is run window AC unit, a washer, or the refrigerator. Those are just crazy on a battery system, so that takes so much power, it's unreal. Anyway, hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks a lot.